Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Fund again. Today I am going to talk about one topic that is recently in news for lot of related to lot of companies. Actually this topic is about loan against shares or pledging of shares. Recently or yesterday only there was complaint by Anil Ambani Group to SEBI regarding doing inquiry about, they had allegations about Edelweiss and L&T Finance etc. Financial entities group, that they were doing insider trading or violating pledge share selling norms etc. Actually what happened, I'll tell you. Anil Ambani Group had so many company shares pledged with Edelweiss or other financial entities. Due to fall in their share prices, Anil Ambani Group shares started to fall, and due to fall in their share prices, Edelweiss etc. group who had their shares pledged with them, they started to sell shares of this Anil Ambani Group companies, due to which in turn again there was fall of amounting to 20 to 30%, 10% etc. in a day was triggered in Anil Ambani Group shares like Reliance Communication, then Reliance Infra, then Reliance Naval, Reliance Capital etc. Actually the Reliance Communication company is on the way of bankruptcy, but as other companies are not on the ways of bankruptcy and they are doing not that well, but they are doing better than Reliance Communication at least, so they were not in negative, but still Anil Ambani was saying that they were not in that condition to be sold in the market, even they are pledged with Edelweiss. So SEBI's letter or explanation came today that they were thinking of doing some inquiry or considering to inquire about all this matter, that why Edelweiss sold shares, or was there any alleged insider trading etc. 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 kind of things were going on. So because of that also Edelweiss company shares, finance wings share was down around 4 to 5% at that time when that news broke out. So one thing that we need to learn or need to understand from all this matter is that what is this pledging of shares and how this is impacting the overall financial sector in Indian financial market. So basically pledging of shares simply means if you are holding a if you are having a company which is listed on stock market, and if you have around suppose 51% or controlling stake in that company, then you can pledge a few percentage of that company. There are so many norms and conditions for pledging of shares. You can pledge with non-related party etc. 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 So many conditions are there laid down by SEBI. So as per those conditions you can pledge 10%, 20%, 30% of share. In this case what happened, Anil Ambani had pledged mostly around in the range of 40 to 80% of various group company shares to various financial institutions and raise money from that. So they pledge the shares of companies and raise that money. So basically so question arises, why they raise money from pledging of shares, that is also called as loan against shares. They take loan against that shares, they pay interest in the form of cash to the lending entity, whatever the financial institution it is. So what is the reason that why such great people or big people who are holding so many companies, who are promoter of many companies, they raise loan against shares? So basically whatever asset these promoters have in their kitty is most of a part is the ownership of or controlling stake in particular company. So whenever they are in need of a cash, whenever they have to service a loan, whenever they have to pay EMI to larger industrial loans etc., so they need cash. If they try to take loan for other entities, it will reflect badly in the balance sheet or it will reflect as a loan. So in their personal capacity they raise loan on the asset they have. That asset is their ownership in particular company. So using that money they can address company's current account requirement or any personal reasons they require for buying any particular asset etc., home etc. kind of thing. So they do it. There are right now there are various companies like Adani Enterprises, then Anil Ambani Group shares, and recently it was in news for that company was in news that was Z Entertainment Private Limited, was the promoter and owner Subhash Chandra had pledged mostly a few percentage shares of its company, and same thing happened with that him also, and he alleged the same way that some people or whom he had borrowed money by lending shares, they were trying to sell those shares in open market and in turn creating negative sentiment for the share. So many companies in Nifty also they have pledged their shares and they are raising money from it. So personally also on individual retail basis you must have observed it in Zerodha like brokerages or ICICI direct like brokerages, you can see that you can pledge whatever holding you have into it, and after haircut, that is if you have 100 rupees valuation share, you get 80 rupees or 70 rupees for that, for trading purposes or for other purposes depending on brokerage, etc. So same way these big company promoters, etc., do, they pledge their shares. If suppose they pledge 10% of their share and they get around 7 to 8% of that value in cash for doing various things. Subhash Chandra of Z Entertainment had pledged few percentage of his ownership, and he got money to service the loan which had defaulted because of so many he got delayed because of so many reasons related to island affairs and infrastructure ventures and wrong decision, etc., etc., for which I have made video in my video section, you can check it out. Okay, so important thing we need to understand from this all matter is that what is the reason that this loan against share is causing a negative impact on overall share. Suppose Anil Ambani Group's particular share is trading at 100 rupees, and if it starts to decline because of some overall market condition or whatever reason, and if it touches to 80, then to whom he had he had borrowed money against his shares, they start to think that if the shares falls even more, it touches 60 or 50. So they had given money when its valuation was 80. So they start to run into panic and they start to offload a few percentage of their ownership of whatever shares they are holding against the loan they have issued. So whenever share price fall, it creates negative sentiment for people from whom they have taken loan. So they start to go into panic and they increase the supply of shares into the market. So our markets are not that liquid compared to European market, etc. Though we are in our Nifty is in top 10 traded option, you can say Nifty option, Nifty index, but still it creates negative sentiments in people who are giving loan to borrowers against shares. So they start to inject those shares into the market, and in turn that creates, even if it is in 1% or 2%, it creates negative sentiment. It creates excess supply of shares in the market that in turn triggers falling of overall price of the shares, though it corrects in the long term, but it temporarily it creates panic. Right now it is created for Anil Ambani Group shares, and very recently it was created for Z Group company shares. So that creates negative impact on shares and shares starts falling. So that is one thing, and a negative thing that gets created. So you just imagine, so suppose if same thing happens, suppose Nifty goes down by few 1-2,000 points in extreme negative condition, just imagine how many more shares will come into market on the fear of falling further. So that is what I think, we are sitting on a big risk in the market. Even Warren Buffett also in his annual reports has advised not to take loan against shares, and he has treated it as one of the dangerous things in overall operating of the business. There is one plus point to this thing also. Whenever a promoter is taking loan against shares or asset he has, he in turn is leveraging his position or his asset. So that is kind of plus point for a business. He is utilizing his asset for creating more cash flow for the company. If he is not using it for personal capacity and helping for overall health of the business, then I think for if the pledging is in the range of, it is my opinion, please don't treat it as a financial advice, etc. So if he is raising money in the range of 5 to 10%, etc., then I think that is a positive move for a company. So that is my move for overall business. If you are raising money from against your loan, so you are overall leveraging the asset you have. Okay, so that was all about loan against shares and pledging. Let's talk something about Nifty. This is a 1 year graph of Nifty. Today market was dragged down heavily by IT shares and HDFC share. There was a lot of unclear understanding in the market about rate cut, because market was thinking that there shouldn't be a rate cut. The budget itself was inflationary in nature, but still the rate cut came. So that is pointing towards some discrepancy in overall financial decisions and actual market conditions. So I think that is what is market is taking little bit negatively. Also people are poised for election, and also the fall in rupee, the strengthening of rupee or fall in dollar, that created negative sentiment for IT companies, because they depend on, I don't think that short term fall in dollar will impact overall earning for IT company, but still it was a kind of negative for IT companies. So that all dragged down Nifty today. And weekly expiries also, it was second day for weekly expiry. So that was my opinion about Nifty and loan against shares or pledging of shares. I hope you liked or you learned something. I try to create videos based on long term approach of overall investing or overall investing thinking, and I do share my understanding related to that only. There are so many YouTube channels and YouTube or other information sources are there, but they talk about short term or 1 or 2 year only. I think we need to keep horizon or thinking of 5 years, 10 years or 15 years for achieving a better investment strategy. So that is what my opinion, and that way also I try to make more and more videos on that. I hope you like it. If you want to see more of such kind of videos, you can check into videos clicking on the Share Market Friend name, and please subscribe to this channel and hit like if you like it. Thank you very much for listening, Share Market Friend.